The 28-goal hero of last season, including a hat-trick in the playoff final, Clive Mendonca, is at last fit again for the Charlton lineup. Cometh the hour, or too late to save the day. Mendonca's partner up front is Steve Jones, a substitute last week, and that makes it a third different pairing in the last three matches. Andy Petterson, who came on for the second half against Blackburn 7 days ago, continues in goal. Otherwise, the lineup is unchanged. Though it's worth noting that Alan Kerbisch's five substitutes do not include a goalkeeper. Dion Dublin has lost his battle to be fit for Aston Villa. A hernia operation to come and problems too with his knees. Gareth Barry comes in for him numerically, although that means a more forward role, I suspect, for Paul Merson. And a moment to pay tribute to a man who certainly will be up front, Julian Joachim, who makes his 100th appearance for Aston Villa, having just collected one of the Player of the Year awards. As ever, good support for Charlton Athletic, and still travelling, hopefully. Mike Riley of Leeds is the man in charge, to be the fourth official at the cup final. Charlton in their change strip. It's a ridiculously cold afternoon for early May, but not quite as cold as when these two teams met in December. First shot of the match from Graham Stuart. And that match at the Valley decided by an own goal in the third minute by the unlucky Richard Rufus. Alan Kerbisch's team, one win in the last 10. Here's Gareth Southgate. Free kick against Redfearn for an untidy challenge on Paul Merson. Taylor is forward. Barry is the furthest across. This is Merson trying to set it up for Alan Wright. And Merson again. And he spurned the early shot away by Carl Tyler. Not a bad try by Mark Draper. Didn't hang about with that one, but it came slightly off the outside of the boot. Statistics very much against Charlton Athletic. Four of the last five sides promoted by the playoffs have gone straight back. Eight of 14 sides promoted in the last five seasons have ended the next season being relegated. Aston Villa captain. Aston Villa, curious end of a season which promised so much for them. They were 3 points clear when they beat Charlton at the Valley just before Christmas. And now ending the season having a say in both top and bottom of the table. Well, he just waited, didn't come for it, the goalkeeper. And Graham Stuart has given Charlton a priceless start. Indecision by the goalkeeper. Looked as though it was going to come straight to him. I really believe that Michael Oakes should have come to claim the ball. Whether it went in off attacker or defender is a point of argument. And it may well have been an own goal by Barry. Well, an early bonus for those who've come up from South London. Probably can't quite believe it at the moment. Here's Merson. Rufus covering by, I don't know, he's given it away! Goalkeeper's ball, and Gareth Barry gets his second goal for Aston Villa in consecutive home games. But Rufus, who conceded the own goal in the meeting of these two sides at the Valley, it's a terrible mistake goalkeeper said leave it. Instead of that, he played it across, and Barry had just a simple opportunity which he took to place the ball in the net. Joachim. Barry well forward again. Corner conceded. Well, I can only feel that Petterson really must up his volume, because he could have come to claim this too. Locked with the hands, says the referee. Draper. Powell, but it was a header across the face. Barry! Now, Rufus felt a bit of venom in that. The game seems to be all about Gareth Barry at the moment. Two went to him. Came off Taylor in the end. Goal kick. Never mind the rain. So much at stake. Started so well, and then the advantage, by no means for the first time, by Charlton, given away. Merson. Played by Taylor. Kinsella. So many back. Needs the long ball to find the front two. Barry with Wright going outside it. The youngster being encouraged to have another crack. And he does. Good left on him, and his left may hold a key to his future. There aren't that many players in the country naturally left-sided at the very top level. Right. Watson didn't make it because Tyler got his head there first. Stone out by Powell. Robinson and Stone having a push and shove, which seemed quite unnecessary. The only thing that Robinson felt that Stone's fall was not required, but there was nothing the matter with the tackle anyway. Charlton desperate not to concede so close to half-time. Need a positive dressing room. And the referee spotting an infringement in the box. Gives Charlton a free kick and is hugely applauded by their supporters, who are in the main behind Petterson's goal. We've had 2 minutes of stoppage time, and we will have no more. And the end of a half which has belonged very much to a young 18-year-old, Gareth Barry, who was involved in both goals, both of them mistakes. I think he was let down by his goalkeeper, but the ball may well have come off his head to give Charlton the lead. Michael Oakes not coming for the ball, but then at the other end, Barry seizing on the error by Richard Rufus to score a simple equaliser. 1-1 at half-time, and I suppose Alan Kerbyshire would settle for that, and you have to say his team have certainly backed up his desire to go for it. And over the years, this has not been the happiest ground for Charlton Athletic. They've only ever won here three times. This is the 20th game. And their record defeat anywhere happened here on November the 14th, 1959. They were beaten 11-1. And one Jerry Hitchens scored five times for Aston Villa. John Gregory, it's been a difficult season. So much promise early on, but so many problems off the pitch. Oh, the bounce has beaten them all. This is Robinson. Oh, dear, another opportunity wasted by Charlton Athletic. Had so much more time than he took. Bounce beating two defenders. And he just didn't really get control of the ball to make a decent cross. 10 minutes of the second half gone. 1-1 the score. Kinsella. Robinson. Give and go, but he hasn't actually gone. So Powell's come inside instead. Stuart. Pass intended for Jones. Barry. What a good ball that is. And Merson almost getting it through to Taylor. Had he done so, that would have been a fine move indeed. Two passes to goal. I think he felt there was a hand in the way of the ball going in. On by Jones. Here's a chance for Mendonca. And he's taken it beautifully. The sort of quality goal that Alan Kirbishley's side have been missing for so much of the season. He then took his time and made it count. Clearance by Petterson. It was a good flick on by Jones. Held off the challenge and found a gap between goalkeeper and post. Southgate slipping in front of him. Charlton have the lead through Mendonca's eighth of the season. Watson. Charlton being pressed back. Wright cleanly struck. And Petterson would have been very happy to see that. Go wide of the angle. Stuart. Redfearn. Good play again by Barry. But Merson dwelling when perhaps he shouldn't have. Mendonca. Jones. Ehiogu. From a seated position, goal kick. More applause from the Charlton supporters. And the determination to keep pressing is surely the right one. The more the match is played up at the end where their supporters are, the more comfortable they'll feel and the team as well. Here's Joachim, and it's the equaliser. What can he be thinking? Joachim delighted with his 15th of the season. Well, it was hoisted forward, and he got a little touch there, which gave Joachim the chance to feed on it. Vassell's nod over Mills was crucial, and the goalkeeper coming out is beaten across him. 2-2. Charlton have to start again. And how cruel are football supporters. You're not singing anymore. They must feel like crying in their soup at the other end. But a good goal for Aston Villa. Here's Mills. Jones. He thought he was being held. Referee thought otherwise. Moment it on their feet. Next minute sitting down, it's a bit of a summary. Rufus. Petterson to Mills. Wright. Southgate. Rufus. Mills. Southgate. Jones trying to get in behind him, muscling his way. And he's done well. Mendonca! Good save! And it's in, surely. Yes. The linesman says, and it's in. Robinson has scored. 3-2, Charlton. What a remarkable match this is turning out to be. Southgate really caught by the determination of Jones. Mendonca, good block. And then Robinson just able to get it over the line before Southgate's clearance. Villa 2, Charlton 3, and now it's the Charlton supporters, you say, you're not singing anymore. Manager said all along he would go to the last game of the season, and he's absolutely determined that that would be the case. Point might be enough to do that, but three would be a great deal better. Jones deserved a lot of credit for that, so did Mendonca. Well, there was a chance for the clearance. Tyler took control and is down in the six-yard area. Barry, oof! Shot with the right foot. Really didn't have too much alternative then. Bumbled a bit on the way. Nobody taking control. Neatly done by Joachim, and there's trouble in the middle. Barry and Robinson. And this time it's Robinson who's hurt. And there's all sorts of push and shove. John Robinson quickly recovers. Right. Here's Barry. It's a really unnecessary foul by Mills, which puts Charlton under threat again. That is by no means quality defending from an England under 21 player. Charge in the middle. And the nod down. Oh, it's a really good save by Petterson. Ball came up for him, but that was the save of the match. Right to take the corner. Barry. Ehiogu. Oh, and it's in. By Joachim again. Barry, then Ehiogu, keep your eyes on Joachim. There were two players on the line, but he was very sharp indeed. Ehiogu managing to turn under pressure from Rufus. Three. Ball was out. Two goals in the match. And he really has had an excellent season. And the gamut of emotions is really surely beyond endurance for Alan Kirvesley, Keith Peacock, Mervyn Day, and anybody who holds the future of Charlton Athletic dear. And here's Joachim again. Petterson comes for the ball and doesn't make it. Oh, he's in trouble now. He's off. The hero a moment ago with a brilliant save. but he came rushing out as he did last week. Wildly missed the ball, took the man, and denied, in the referee's opinion, Joachim the chance to go on and put the ball in. And there is no substitute goalkeeper for Charlton Athletic. Going to be Steve Brown, who's played the role before. Comes off the substitutes bench. John Robinson, the player who's withdrawn. The man who a few moments ago thought he'd probably scored the most important goal in Charlton Athletic's history. Did well enough on a previous occasion, immediately facing the free kick and making a good save. Joachim blocked, didn't know too much about it, away by Powell. Well, it's a good save by Brown. Two minutes remaining. This is Barry. Started it all, couldn't find the shot to finish it all. Jones, well on, Pringle, this is a chance, he was pulled back by Watson. There's going to be another dismissal here, I think. I think Steve Watson will be dismissed for that fullback, because Pringle was on with a chance. There were two other players there that might have got across, but it is red, and I think that's right. So, both sides down to 10 men, there was a definite pull there. Southgate may have got to him and there was another man further over, but I think Mr. Riley was right in that decision. Away goes the disappointed Steve Watson. Free kick to Charlton Athletic. John Barnes, Mark Kinsella, Graham Stuart and Danny Mills! Wonderful! Goal in the 90th minute. Charlton lead 4-3. Beautifully done. Straight down the slot. Slight deflection. Took it away from Oakes. What a calm free kick in such circumstances. And a strike. Got a little touch off right, I think. But no matter to those behind the goal. Misery, despair, delight have been mixed in equal measures. No wonder the lip is being bit. The knuckles gnawed at. And it won't be until they get to the dressing room, won't they? No. How much it will all matter. Vassell, it's done well until he hit the cross. It's down to 2 minutes and it's unbearable. Pull back to nobody in particular. Mills can hike it clear. Southgate. Southgate. Ehiogu. Wright. Well seen by Pringle. Ehiogu. It's too long. Huge applause for Steve Brown. I can't believe he looks so calm. Barry. Taylor. Pringle. John Gregory collects the ball. Vassell. Barry. Taylor. The last 10 seconds, it's Southgate. And it's out by the captain, Kinsella. And he, the last player to play the ball. An amazing match reaches its conclusion. Danny Mills' goal proves decisive. Scored in the 90th minute. And the full gamut of emotions have been run by the Charlton team and their supporters. Four times in front, and the last time they managed to stay there. Stuart involved in the first goal, although both goals of the first period scored by Gareth Barry. Mendonca put Kirbish's side in front, so did Robinson, but both found equalisers from Joachim. And then Kinsella's calm free kick set up the chance for Danny Mills to rifle the ball home and to keep Charlton Athletic alive, they hope.
That was a season in one match, wasn't it?
Well, we had a very similar game, didn't we, at Wembley exactly a year ago, really. But I'd like to get the tape on that and have another look at it, because I think for yous, it must have been a fantastic game to watch.
Was it fantastic for you to watch, or was it murder?
Well, I honestly believe, and I said to the players before the game, it's in our hands still. I honestly believe that if it didn't go for us today, I didn't think it would go for the other teams either. I firmly believe it was going to go to the last weekend. I still firmly believe that, and I firmly believe we're not going to go down.
We're very disappointed the way we're letting goals today. Obviously, you know, to lead and lead again, to keep getting pegged back, you know, really sums up our season. You know, we've gone ahead, we've let in a bad goal, and it's cost us dear. Thankfully today, we've nicked one in the last few minutes, and we've got ourselves out of it.
I think you're rather deprecating yourself, nicked one. I thought you hit that rather well.
Yeah, I've not seen it yet, but obviously I think it might, you know, hit a couple of people on the way through. But I'll definitely claim that one, I think. I don't think the lads will begrudge me that.
We've thrown away a few points. I think we got back in the game against Everton, ended up losing that. 1-0 up against Middlesbrough, ended up drawn. 1-0 up against Coventry, ended up losing. We chucked away 12 or 13 points. We should be sitting nice and easy in the middle of the table, but no one chatting, and this is the way we do it. We go to the wire.
Well, there you are. That's the position at the bottom right now. Southampton's destiny is in their own hands. If they win their final game at home to Everton, they will be the ones to stay up, and Blackburn and Charlton would take the drop. It was in seven games. They scored four today, and their desire to win that match was absolutely fantastic.
Oh, it was amazing. I'm worn out just watching it this afternoon, Des. And it had a bit of everything. A fantastic advert for the Premier League, for entertainment, for excitement, and for how really not to defend, but also how to take the lead four times and eventually hold on to it. You know, your goalkeeper got sent off. There's another sending off in the game. And you just felt with Charlton going into the game, they must have thought, well, Blackburn would win at home against Nottingham Forest, and Southampton taking all those supporters to Wimbledon, and thinking, well, maybe they might just sneak a result. So for Charlton to actually win the game, I thought was fantastic for them. And I think what they did, because it was like a drastic situation, calls for desperate measures. They went kind of route one, you know, and they played the direct route throughout the game, and it worked dividends for them. This is Petterson, the goalkeeper, just launching it down the field. And Jones is the man who gets a touch. It's a great touch on, and Southgate's the wrong side of his man, which is Mendonca, and he stays on his feet. You thought for a moment he might just have delayed it too long, but he certainly didn't, and he got them the goal. Again, Mills, one of the stars for them today, just playing the ball, really, you know, around the back of Aston Villa. Again, it's Southgate involved with Jones, and Jones is, I mean, he's scrapping for his life here. He wins the ball in a situation he should never win. He knows Southgate can't make the tackle. Good ball into Mendonca, saved by Oates, and there's Robinson in it, and it was definitely a goal. And this is Brown. This was after he'd made come on and he made his save. Again, it was route one. Flicked on. And this is where, you know, it was Pringle running through. Watson brings him down. Absolutely no doubt whatsoever. He had to go off. And it was from that free kick that Danny Mills scored the fourth goal. This is just funny because this was Brown coming onto the field of play. He's been the emergency goalkeeper before. He just got on, he just lined the wall up. He's screaming at them already. He just about pulled his gloves on. I mean, we'd never get save of the month, but it was certainly worth
it. Effective, though.
Oh, it was absolutely brilliant. And I think after that, he thought, well, this just wasn't too bad. But that really summed up their day for them. You know, the fact they had to just chuck him on, they didn't have a substitute goalkeeper. And I'm sure when Brown came on, Alan Kirby, she thought, we're not going to get anything from this game.
Well, they're home to Sheffield Wednesday next week, but it might not be enough even if they win it, of course.
Well,
now,
of course, you rely on Southampton, which is a problem. But, of course, I think certainly the fact that they just got that win today, which will just lift everybody at the football club. And Sheffield Wednesday wouldn't be the worst game in the world, your last game at home.
Match now, it is Everton against West to Middlesbrough tomorrow. Southampton's first away win since November has left them firm favourites to survive. They're now quoted at 3-1 on to stay up. Charlton to 4 after their first win in 6 games. They have to beat Sheffield Wednesday next Sunday to have any chance of remaining in the Premiership. Blackburn are a remote 12-1 shot now to avoid relegation. Their fate could be settled before next weekend. If they don't beat Manchester United on Wednesday, they will be down. Worked a miracle this afternoon. It's Alan Kirbishley. From us, it's good night.
That's life.
That's life.
And as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream. But I don't let it get me down, 'cause this fine old world, it keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life.
That's life.
I tell you, I can't deny it. I thought of quitting, baby, but my heart just ain't gonna buy it. And if I didn't think it was worth one single try, I'd jump right on a big bird and then I'd fly.